मॉर्निंग वंस अगेन टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे इन द मैथमेटिक्स पेडागोजी पेपर वी विल हैव अ डिस्कशन ओवर द नेचर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विच इज ऑल्सो इन अवर सिलेबस. एंड हियर वी विल डिस्कस दैट वाई अंडरस्टैंडिंग द नेचर ऑफ अ डिसिप्लिन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट first thing, and then we will see that what are the specific nature of mathematics are, what are the different specific nature of mathematics is. Okay, so these two things we will see. So the first of part of the discussion, that why we are studying the nature of any discipline before teaching that subject or a paper. Means suppose that I want to teach a mathematics or I want to teach a science, then why it is necessary to study about the nature of that science and mathematics, or a social science, or it may be a language also, no harm. So why we study? So the answer of the this part we will get at the end, because first we will try to discuss the nature of mathematics, and from that we will try to build the answer of that why we are studying the nature of mathematics in order to teach the pedagogy. Because from my experience, I have experienced that majority of a student have a question that we have studied one pedagogy like a physical science, or for arts student like a language. So why we are studying the another pedagogy? Because we know the methods of teaching, we are competent enough in the making the lesson plans and all other things. So why it is required to study about another pedagogy once again? So this answer we will get. So when we talk about the nature of mathematics as the other discipline and other subject, mathematics also have a distinct characteristics. It has a distinct characteristics which is entirely different from the other subject, other discipline or a set of concepts. The set of concept in mathematics is entirely different from the other concepts or other disciplines. When we see mathematics and when we see the history of that, how the mathematics has been originated, how the mathematics has come, we find that mathematics has come out of the necessity of the numerical aspect of the life, numeracy. It was felt that there is a necessity of a numeracy, there is a necessity of a number. Suppose that when the people, when they were getting civilized, so they were doing animal husbandry, they were keeping the cows and buffaloes and the goats. So they were thinking that how many I have, and when I take them to forest and when I bring them back in the night, so whether I have some cattle missing or not, or is it there that some cattle from the other group has come to my group. So they felt the necessity to address this question, and as a necessity of this type of a problem, they have devised one strategy. One, they once in the morning when they were sending the cattle to the forest, they were counting the it by the stones, piece of a stone, so that one cattle will go out, then they will keep one stone in the bag, another cattle another stone in the bag, so like that. And when the cattle was were coming back to the home in the night, they again they were matching the stone, but they found that it's a very difficult, because suppose that I have hundreds of cow and some object, hundreds of objects. It's very difficult to keep the hundreds of stones. And if by chance if any stone will miss or any stone will be added, then the whole mathematics will be gone. So the necessity is came. And it also felt that when they were growing up, the civilization was growing up, they felt the idea of necessity of exchanging the commodity. Suppose that I have a milk and you have a grain, so I can exchange the milk with the grain, kind of a thing. But without the numeracy, numerical numbers, it was a bit a difficult task. So they have coined, they have invented the numbers, and from there the mathematics originates. And the nowadays we have a different types of mathematics, different branch, not the type, different branches of mathematics, that is has come out of the necessity only. So mainly when we see mathematics, it is a quantitative in nature, numerical in nature. When we talk about the mathematics, it is a quantitative. In mathematics, we don't talk about the qualitative aspect of a phenomena or object. We talk about the quantitative aspect of a phenomena or object. I will not say that this pen is pink and white color. That is a qualitative part. I will say this is one pen, number is one, or this is of 5-inch length. That is a quantitative part. So mathematics always deals with the quantitative part. It will never deal with the qualitative part. So mathematics is quantitative in nature, numerical in nature. Numeracy is the prime focus of mathematics. Here we are focusing on the numeracy. Here we are focusing on the quantitative part. Whenever the question of mathematics will come, quantitative part will obviously come. Or without the quantitative part, we cannot solve the mathematical problem. Even if it is not in the quantitative form, we have to convert it in order to solve. Without converting, solving is not possible. Even the application of mathematics is not possible. Suppose that you may have come across a word kind of a problem, that the son's is one third of the father's is, and after some time this gap, this type of a relationship happens. That is the word kind of a problem. But here the scope of quantification of a problem has a scope, is a possible. And when you will quantify, then only you will be able to solve. So quantification is the one of the important aspect in the mathematics. Okay, so that is one. The next thing when we talk about that, as I have discussed in some other classes also, that every subject, everything have its own language. And a language is a nothing but it's a set of a symbol. Like that, when I am talking in the English, it is written in the Roman, and the Roman have a 26 symbols. Character is a symbol, and by meaningful arrangement of a those symbol, we use to make a word, and with the meaningful arrangement of a word, we used to make a sentence by which we are expressing the feeling. Suppose that I am saying this is a pen. So this is the concept. Pen is a concept, but it is represented by a symbol, that the P-E-N, pen. That is the written symbol, alphabetical symbol that can be written. The things I am speaking, it is the verbal symbol. So likewise, English have its own symbol, Hindi have its own symbol, to express the idea. Even Oriya have its own symbol to express the idea. Like that, mathematics have its own symbol, set of symbols. It is a symbolic in nature. It has its own symbol. Geography may not be having its own set of a symbol. Science may not be having its own set of a symbol, but science also have some distinct set of symbols. Like that, when we are studying about the political science may not have its own set of a symbol, but mathematics has its own set of a symbol. And unless or until we are very competent enough in understanding the meaning of a symbol, in using at an appropriate place, it will be very difficult to learn the mathematics. We cannot learn mathematics effectively with knowing the set of a symbol from English or Hindi or Oriya. Obviously, those language is required in order to express your ideas or a feeling. But when particularly we are studying in mathematics, you must be very competent enough in understanding using the specific symbol of a mathematics. Like that, you must have seen lambda, phi, theta. Okay. There are lots of mathematical symbol. We use mathematics, therefore, ke liye there is another symbol. If I am trying to say since, there is another set of symbol. There exist, there is another set of a symbol. Even in geometry, to denote the parallel lines, we have another set of a symbol. Congruency, we have a set of a symbol. So without knowing, it is a difficult. You may have a question, sir, I don't know the symbolic representation symbol for the congruency. I don't know that how to denote the parallel lines or equal to or since, then, there exist, but still I can learn mathematics. How? I will write there exist. You are right. Suppose that I am writing 60 degrees. So 60 and degrees denoted by the upper case in zero. Okay. So you will write, will not write the symbolic 60 degree, but you will write that 60 degree essay. I will write. So why I cannot study mathematics? I can study mathematics with using those symbols. Okay, but if you have a feeling like that, can I know that how many of you have a feeling like that? Without using the mathematical symbol, I can learn mathematics. May I know? Hello.
If we don't write degree in upper of 60,
yes,
can I write degree? Yes.
This is an example given by me. I am asking from you. This is the example I have given. Do you think that without using a mathematical symbol and a notation, you can learn mathematics? Do you think? Can you repeat once?
It is the lingering process.
Okay. Other people? Asutosh Sahu? And then Asis?
Sir,
it is not possible. Why it is not possible, Asis?
Sir,
Sir,
as
as
you
you said,
said, degree
degree can
can
be
be
changed
changed
to
to
letter,
letter,
then
then
percentage
percentage
also
also
can
can
be
be write
write in
in
letter.
letter.
हाँ, we can write. Why not? We can write. अच्छा,
नंबर
हाँ, नंबर कैन बी
कैन
ऑल्सो,
भी
हाँ, दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटर्न. वाई नॉट? अच्छा, सो आई विल कम टू दिस.
सर
हाँ,
सर, बट
बट
यू
यू
विल
विल
बी
बी
वेरी
वेरी
स्लो
स्लो
इन
इन
कैलकुलेशन,
कैलकुलेशन,
मतलब
मतलब
यू
यू
विल
विल
मेक
मेक
मिस्टेक
मिस्टेक
एट
एट
वेरी प्लेसेस.
ओके ओके, आई विल
इट इज
कम.
द
ओके
पॉसिबिलिटी.
ओके, आई विल कम दिस क्वेश्चन जस्ट आफ्टर फ्यू मिनट. ओके, सो दिस इज द वन ऑफ द नेचर वी हैव सीन, दैट इज इट इज सिम्बॉलिक इन नेचर. अनदर, वेन वी सी दैट इट हैज अ स्पेसिफिक लैंग्वेज, इट इज हैविंग द डिस्टिंक्ट लैंग्वेज, इट हैज अ स्पेसिफिक लैंग्वेज. लाइक दैट द लैंग्वेज वी हैव इंग्लिश, हिंदी, ओरिया, लाइक दैट द लैंग्वेज वी हैव. मैथमेटिक्स ऑल्सो हैव इट्स डिस्टिंक्ट लैंग्वेज ऑफ राइटिंग एंड एक्सप्रेसिंग द मैथमेटिकल आइडियाज. सपोज दैट वेन यू राइट ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी प्लस बी स्क्वायर, दिस इक्वेशन इज सिंबलाइजिंग अ पर्टिकुलर आइडिया, इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स अ पर्टिकुलर आइडिया, इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स अ पर्टिकुलर मैथमेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट, इजंट इट? सो वेन एवर वी आर राइटिंग अ मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन, एक्चुअली वी आर ट्राइंग टू कम्युनिकेट सम कॉन्सेप्ट थ्रू दोज मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशंस, एंड दैट इक्वेशन इज इन द मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज. मैथमेटिक्स हैव इट्स ऑन डिस्टिंक्ट मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज, एंड इफ वी डोंट नो द डिस्टिंक्ट मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज एंड द डिस्टिंक्ट मैथमेटिकल सिंबल्स, देन इट इज आफ्टर सम टाइम इट इज इम्पॉसिबल, इट इज नॉट डिफिकल्ट, इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू स्टडी द मैथमेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट. आई एम टेलिंग, आप यू जस्ट गो एंड सी द मैथमेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट गिवन इन द टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ 6, 7, 8, 9, क्लास 10. ओके, एंड ट्राई टू स्टडी एंड सॉल्व दोज प्रॉब्लम विदाउट यूजिंग द मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज एंड मैथमेटिकल सिंबल. यू विल फाइंड दैट यू आर एबल टू डू द मैथमेटिक्स, यू आर एबल टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम, हाउ एवर यू आर फेसिंग अ लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्टी. इट्स ओके, बट यू गो टू द हायर मैथमेटिक्स, मैथमेटिक्स इन द हायर क्लासेस लाइक अ कैलकुलेशन सेट थ्योरी, ओके, और अदर मैथमेटिक्स विच वी स्टडी इन प्लस टू और अ ग्रेजुएशन. एंड द मैथमेटिक्स विच इज इन द ग्रेजुएशन ट्राई टू सॉल्व द मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम विदाउट यूजिंग अ सिंगल मैथमेटिकल सिंबल्स एंड सिंगल मैथमेटिकल लैंग्वेज. यू विल फाइंड दैट इज हैज मिस्ड अ सच अ वे दैट यू कैन नॉट प्रोसीड फर्दर. And the mathematical problem that can be solved within this much of paper, suppose that this much of a paper, it will take a 20 paper, 20, 30 paper it will take. So it becomes difficult, and that's why we expect that if the child is not competent enough in mathematical language and mathematical symbols, then it will be difficult for them to study mathematics. Okay. Can we study geometry? Trigonometry without I am saying it is a very difficult to study the mathematics without knowing the symbol and a language. So if I am saying mathematics means it includes all the branches. Specifically asking that can we study the geometry or can we study trigonometry, I think doesn't have any sense. Okay. आई एम सेइंग ना इट इज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट और इट इज इम्पॉसिबल ओके आफ्टर सम टाइम सो ऑब्वियसली इट इज अ डिफिकल्ट यू कैन नॉट स्टडी कैन नॉट इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट और what I said you don't understood I am saying after some time it is impossible initially it may be possible is it okay Asutosh बचपन से आप क्यों लिखे हैं ना क्योंकि उन सारी चीजों को जनरलाइज करके एक सिस्टमिक रूप में डेवलप किया गया है ना बचपन से जैसे मान लीजिए कि why you have studied a plus b का whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square because when the mathematics was developing and when the mathematician were contributing in the field of mathematics they have come across these hurdles and they have come across come with the solution also so the you are saying that if we could have used PLUSC since a childhood we could have been able to do that it is not appropriate because the earlier mathematicians those who were doing mathematics they have felt the same kind of a hurdle and that's why they have come with a solution when you will find see the development of a different branches of mathematics initially as I have told one story that initially mathematics developed the with the felt necessity of a numeracy and a number because they were feeling difficulty in accounting in a business in exchanging they were feeling that's why they have developed the number but later on the other branches of mathematics has been developed due to the other felt necessity like that when you see the calculus who developed the calculus do you know anybody who developed the calculus anybody calculus is developed by Newton and how it was developed he was actually when we see the contribution of a Newton in science you will find that Newton has contributed almost all area of science he has worked in optics he has worked in everything electrics electromagnetism magnetism sab mein in every area he has worked so when he was working in the astronomy science he was trying to calculate he found out that it's a very difficult to calculate with the existing mathematical concepts available so he developed calculus basic idea of a calculus and later on it was developing and so many people has contributed in that also I am not saying that Newton was the alone who is responsible for the contribution in the calculus but basic idea is developed by the Newton and it was due to the felt necessity so whatever you are saying Kavita it's not like that It is not like that since the childhood you have written like that and so you will be able to do that no so many people have failed to do that okay is it okay
sir ha
centimeter meter ka to symbol nahi hai usko to letter mein likhna padta hai na phir bhi
uska shortcut hai na cm aur m
acha
wo to letter hi hai na
अच्छा अच्छा सुनो 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 ऐसे नहीं करते आपस में बात करेंगे तो फिर हम इधर किस लिए हैं ठीक है सेंटीमीटर और जो मीटर है ना, ये यूनिट है, यूनिट ऑफ मेजर, जैसे केजी बोलेंगे, सेंटीमीटर बोलेंगे, इंच बोलेंगे, जो भी है, ये सब यूनिट ऑफ मेजरमेंट है. यूनिट ऑफ मेजरमेंट इज अ नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. आई टोल्ड यू दैट मैथमेटिक्स डील्स विद द क्वांटिफिकेशन, डील्स विद द क्वांटिटी. इफ आई विल टेल 5 सेंटीमीटर, 5 इज अ मैथमेटिक्स. ओके, एंड 5 हैव अ डिस्टिंक्ट वैल्यू. आई विल टेल यू हाउ. ये सब आपको थोड़ा पढ़ना होगा कि कैसे अलग अलग जो यूनिट ऑफ मेजरमेंट है वो कैसे डेवलप हुआ. ओके, बट दैट आई विल नॉट डिस्कस बिकॉज दिस इज द बियॉन्ड द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ दिस क्लास. बिकॉज इफ आई विल स्टार्ट डिस्कसिंग लाइक दैट, इट विल क्रिएट अ एंडलेस काइंड ऑफ अ डिस्कशन. वी कैनॉट गेट द एंड. सो हाउ द यूनिट वाज डेवलप्ड, यू कैन जस्ट गूगल इट, यू विल गेट. यू जस्ट गूगल इट, 1 kg, वॉट इज मीन्स. ठीक है, 1 kg डजेंट मीन एनी थिंग, इट्स अ स्टोन. ठीक है, ये स्टोन है, वो शायद ब्रिटेन में रखा हुआ है, उसी का वेट को हम लोग 1 kg मान लिए. सो फिर उसके बाद यदि इट विल बी मल्टीप्लाई 200, देन इट विल बिकम 110. इफ इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू द 1000 part, देन इट विल बिकम द 1 gram. ओके, ऐसे इट हैज बीन डेवलप्ड. लाइक द सिमिलर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ लेंथ इज ऑल्सो देयर. सो दीज थिंग्स आर द यूनिट. यूनिट इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. द क्वांटिटी असाइंड टू द यूनिट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. आई थिंक समटाइम इन द सम क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द क्लासरूम ऑल्सो व्हेन वी वर हैविंग द फेस टू फेस क्लास, दैट व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द क्वांटिटी, क्वांटिफिकेशन, इट ऑल्सो डजेंट मीन एनी थिंग बिकॉज इट्स अ सिंबल. And symbol represents something. Means represents means what? It is associated with something. I think sometime I have discussed with you, or I was discussing with Ahmed. When we talk about the language and a communication, language and a communication is basically dependent upon the symbols and a set of symbols. So if I talk P, only P. Okay, or N or E, does it mean anything? No, it doesn't mean anything. P or E or N doesn't mean anything. But when we arrange it, P, E, N, it also doesn't mean anything. But we have associated the systemic arrangement of a P, then E, then N, pen, with this object, then it means something. Alone P, E, N was not meaning anything. I have associated that arrangement of an alphabet to this object. Okay. Similarly, we arrange P, A, P, E, R, paper in that sequence. Again, it doesn't mean anything because it's a set of a symbol arranged in a some sequence. But we have associated that sequence with this object and ye paper hai. So earlier symbol was not there. In order to communicate in the written form, we were drawing the picture of a pen. ऐसे pen बोल लिखना है तो pen का picture बना दिया. Mouse करना है तो mouse तो उस समय नहीं था. Okay, जो भी करना है उसका ये बना दिया picture. And even we were not having the verbal samples. We were talking with this science language. So the necessity felt. Necessity was that it is a very difficult. So, in order to overcome those difficulty, a set of symbol is developed. And see how beautifully now we are communicating. And like that in mathematics, when we talk about the symbol 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I told you that initially we were using the stone. Ek guy gaya, ek stone. Dusra gaya, dusra stone. Tisra gaya, tisra stone. Aise. But we felt that it's very difficult. Bhai, itna stone kaun lekar ke ghumte rahega patthar ka? So we have associated aise one. Aise likha na one. So this represents the singularity of an object. One, the symbol of a one, and that's why you will find the symbol of a one concept is the same. Suppose that I say one pen, pen ek alag concept hai, one is a quantity, or a five pen bolte hain, five is a quantity, pen is a commodity. So in order to write the symbol of a five quantity, symbol in Roman is a different, Hindi is a different, Oriya in a different, hai na, different hai na symbol, but it represents the same quantity. So that symbol doesn't mean we have associated, and one is associated with the singularity of an object, two is associated with the two singularity of an object, three is associated with the three singularity of an object, four is associated with the four singularity of object, and so on. Okay, this is the basic concept behind the development of a number, and that's why it is a symbolic. Mathematics is symbolic. It deals with the numbers, quantification, qualitative part it won't. Okay, up to here it is okay to you. Shall we move to the next thing? Or you have any question? I think you don't have. Okay, then the next thing, when we see the mathematics is the abstract. Mathematical concepts are the abstract concept. They are not concrete concept. How? When we see, suppose that when we are talking about the science, suppose that the biology. Okay, so in the life science, the different concept, suppose that we are studying about the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis we cannot see, right? But we can demonstrate the process of photosynthesis. In physical science, gravitation we cannot see, right? But we can feel and demonstrate the effect of gravitation. Or in the social science, or in the humanities, we can observe or feel or see or can demonstrate the phenomena of those disciplines, isn't it? Suppose that we are talking about the democracy in the political science. We see the democracy. We have a Bal Sansad, children's parliament in the school, to demonstrate the functioning of a democracy and a parliament. In chemistry, we can demonstrate the chemical reactions, but in mathematics, it is very difficult to demonstrate the mathematical concept. Suppose that when we talk about the point, can you demonstrate point? Can you draw a point? No, perfect point you cannot draw, because that point is a dimensionless. When I am talking about the line, can you draw? No, because the line is a in one dimension, we cannot draw. Can you draw a square or a circle? No, Even can you show the number? How many of you thinks that they can show the number? Can you show the number? Suchismita? Suchismita, are you here? Suchismita Behra? I think. Acha. Can you show the number? Can number be shown?
No.
Ansuman, can you show the number? Ansuman, are you here? Ansuman नहीं है, इसका attendance खत्म कर दो आज का. Those who are responsible for the attendance, please take care that Ansuman is not present. Okay, so you remove his name. वो ऐसा करके ऑन करके शायद
चार मेरा माइक ऑफ हो रहा था, मैं बोल रहा हूँ कुछ सुनाई नहीं दे रहा.
ओके अच्छा
सॉरी सर.
ओके नो प्रॉब्लम. मैं सोचा आप लॉग इन करके फिर कहीं चलेंगे
घूमने. ऐसे कैसे करो?
क्या करूँ, दिमाग है मेरा सोच लेता है ऐसा. चलो आप नंबर दिखा सकते हैं. कैन यू शो द नंबर? पता नहीं. अच्छा मैं बताता हूँ, पता नहीं तो कोई बात नहीं. सी मैं कभी कभी ये क्वेश्चन क्लास में पूछता हूँ, कैन यू शो द नंबर? बोलेंगे हाँ सर आई कैन शो. मैं बोला तीन नंबर दिखाओ, तो बोलेंगे देखो तीन नंबर है. मैं बोलूँगा चार नंबर दिखाओ, फोर, बोलेंगे देखो चार है. मैं बोला पाँच दिखाओ, बोलेंगे देखो पाँच है. आप मुझे बताइए कि suppose that I am considering of number 3. अरे कहाँ जा रहा है. suppose that this is, है ना, suppose that
सर नंबर एक representation है अपना imagination का, जो भी imagination.
yes you are right Anshu. So suppose that I am showing this in the name of number 3. actually this is not number 3, this is 3 objects, it is not number. Number is a symbolic representation that cannot be shown, and the base of mathematics is a quantification. Base of mathematics is a numeracy, and the numeracy deals with the number which cannot be shown. Geometry, the basic of a geometry is line, point, line segment, ray, plane, ऐसे, that cannot be shown because the definition is something else, and whatever you will show in the name of that will be something else. You are defining a point as it is a dimensionless, no depthness, no thickness, no breadth, कुछ नहीं, length, breadth, thickness, कुछ नहीं. But when the moment you will draw even the tiny to tiny point, it will have a some sort of a length and breadth and a thickness. Not possible. You are showing that this is a plane. It is not possible because it should not have a thickness. It has a thickness. Okay. So this is the distinct nature, distinct characteristics of mathematics, and that's why mathematics needs a distinct set of strategy to teach mathematics. As the first question, there are other nature also that we will discuss in the next class. Okay, but we have discussed 2-3 okay. we have seen 2-3. Please switch off your microphone. We have seen 2-3 nature, and by that, by seeing those things, we can build a conclusion that knowing only the different aspect of a pedagogy is not sufficient enough to teach any subject. In order to teach the subject, you must be sound in the content part, and you must have a very clear cut understanding about the nature of a discipline, because nature will decide what kind of a pedagogical treatment you are required to do, what are the pedagogical strategy that is required to adapt, what are the assistive device or a teaching learning device is required to be used. If you will fail, it will be difficult. We can learn social science or a language with a different strategy. In the language or in the social science, the scope of experimentation is less, but in mathematics the scope of experimentation and demonstration is there. And when we talk about the science, it is basically based upon the observation, experimentation, demonstration and hands-on experiences. So see, both of these three are differing, and that's why it is difficult to teach a subject without having a clear cut understanding about the pedagogy of that nature of that discipline. And that's why here the implication of a nature of a discipline in pedagogy comes. Without knowing the nature, you cannot teach. Simple funda. If you know the content but you don't know the characteristics nature of the discipline, you cannot teach. You are not supposed to, because you will not able to decide what set of a strategy will work. Okay, what set of even the strategy for evaluation will work, because the nature of knowledge is different in mathematics than the science, than the social science, than the language. Is it clear to you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Here we will have a small question answer session, and after that we will stop this class. Okay, so if you have any question, please raise your question.
Sir, can we imagine zero?
इमेजिन करने का क्या बात है, इसमें तो जीरो तो होता है, इसमें आप इमेजिन क्या करेंगे?
सर
जीरो का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है ना, जो अप टू हाई स्कूल लेवल तक जीरो का कॉन्सेप्ट है एब्सेंस ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. See, I am showing, I have a three object, I have a two object, I have a one object, I don't have anything, that is a zero. How many object you have? Nothing I have, that is a zero. How many object you have? Single, one. How many object you have? Two. But I don't have any object, that is a zero. Okay, this is the concept of a zero. Absence of the object. You don't have object. Asutosh, is it okay to you?
Okay, sir.
So, any other question? मतलब आपका कहने का है कि ग्रीक का हम कैसे समझे, हमारे वाले ग्रीक कैसे समझे. सी व्हेन वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द नॉलेज फ्रॉम द अदर सेट ऑफ अ सिंबल, इट इज रिक्वायर्ड दैट समवन मस्ट ट्रांसलेट इट फॉर यू. सपोज दैट यू नो द हिंदी, इंग्लिश एंड ओरिया, बट वट एवर द नॉलेज इज अवेलेबल इन तमिल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टडी, or any Tamilian who don't know in the Hindi or Oriya, if they want to study the knowledge available in the Oriya, how it will happen? It will happen if someone will translate it for you. Simple sa cheez hai. But how that had, how it happened at that time, okay, wo us samay kaise hua? It was possible because of the necessity of exchange of the knowledge. There was a necessity to exchange the knowledge because all the society, developing society, we are not having all type of a knowledge. So it was a necessity to exchange the knowledge. The second thing, when you will find the history, when you will see the history, majority of the exchange of the knowledge has happened with by the travelers who were traveling from one place to another place, and those who were doing the business. Okay, they have explored like that. There is a traveler Vin Sang, who was also a student of Nalanda University. When we find the authentic source of a knowledge about the Nalanda University, it is the Vin Sang who has written. Okay, so by that way the knowledge was being exchanged. So that was the thing. Obviously, if there is a some other language means in some other code, and you know the some other code, so you won't be able to understand unless or until it is translated for you. Okay, Asutosh.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So I think now we can stop the class. Thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.